what I'm going to do is pull up the music and give you a chance to take a screenshot. So go ahead, violins. This is your music. Violas, go ahead. This is for you. And then cello and bass. And I'm going to go back to the violin page, but if you're a viola, cello, or bass player, you can just pull yours up right over the video. You don't even have to really see me as long as you can hear me while I'm talking and playing. So we're going to start with this C major scale. You can see that it is a C major scale. You can see that it's going up by note, but there's a little bit of a different rhythm. So the first note, the C, is four eighth notes. The second note of the scale, our D, is two quarter notes, and it goes eighth note, quarter note, all the way through. So there's a little bit of a pattern. We call that the pepperoni pizza rhythm. We were used to playing that rhythm from earlier this year. That first note might look a little bit strange because we don't play it as often as you will after this lesson. You're going to start playing it quite a bit. That first note is C. If you are a violin or viola, that's three fingers on the G string. Cello is four fingers on the G string. And bass, yours is a little bit different, two fingers on the A string. And that note sounds like this. So go ahead and take a second. You can pause if you have to, see if you can find that note. You might need to build up to it like this. And I would encourage you to do that because we want to make sure we start in tune, okay? So we have that C. We'll play out. Let's just play it note by note. We're going to forget about the rhythms for a minute. So we have C. The next note in that scale is D. That should be easy. Open D for everybody. The next note is E. Now we get to the note F, and here's what we have to ask ourselves. We probably should have done this before we started playing, but we'll stop right now and discuss this. We have to ask ourselves, is this an F natural or an F sharp? And the only way we can tell if it's an F natural or an F sharp is to look at the key signature. So if we look over in between our clef and our time signature, the numbers, we should see either sharps or flats or nothing. And in this case, we don't see anything. And that's telling us that all of our notes are natural. So when we go back to the F, that is an F natural, and we have to make sure that we play the correct pitch there. So if you are a violin or viola, remember that F natural means that your second and first fingers are touching. You don't have a space like you normally would. You back it right up, and that's called a half step. They're close to one another. Cello and bass, it's a little bit easier for you. You just use your second finger. Normally you'd have either three or four fingers to play F sharp. And to play F natural, you just put two fingers down. So it's a little bit easier on the cello and bass end, but you do have to remember that it's a different finger. So we had C, D, E. Now we're on F natural. Now the note G. A. B. And our last note is C, and we know from looking at the key signature, it is a C natural. So that's low two or second finger, depending on what instrument you play. And that's the ascending or going up C major scale. If we add the rhythm to it, let me play it once for you, and then I'll have you try it with me. It'll sound like this. Remember, the big thing is getting those F naturals and C naturals. So let's give this a try. You have your first note ready to go, your fingers down. We're going to do this in the middle of the bow. Ready, and here we go. Before we go back, actually, let's go back down and then I'll say what I have to say here. We're going backwards here, starting on the C natural, the high C natural. Ready, go. Awesome. This is a really good scale to play, and you kind of have to be your own teacher on this as you're playing. You know what a major scale sounds like. We play major scales every orchestra class and most lessons to warm up. So you know when something sounds a little off with a scale. If you're playing along and something doesn't sound right, chances are either your natural note isn't correct, or maybe you're not reaching high enough for that G. So your E and F natural are close, so your first and second finger are close together. Now there's a little bit of an extra reach with that third finger for violins and violas. That tends to be a pretty common mistake. And again, cellos, you might have to reach a little further with that fourth finger too. Well, it's going to feel like you're reaching a little bit further with your fourth finger. So if you're playing and it sounds like this, this is a pretty good indication that you're doing something incorrect. That sounds off. So you should be able to tell. We've played lots of scales. You should be able to tell if it is sounding in tune or not. Okay, so there's our C major scale. We're going to take that same idea of those low twos or second fingers, depending on what instrument you're on, and apply it to this tune, Buffalo Gals. So let's get our music out of the way first, and then we'll kind of take a look at what we're dealing with. This is for violins. Go ahead and take a screenshot. Okay, violas. And cello bass. All right, let me back it up here to my violin music. And we're going to break this, like we often do, into four measure segments here. So there's going to be four sections that we deal with. We're going to start with our first four measures. And the interesting thing about these first four measures is we don't have to play any of those low two notes. And by the way, I just want to point out, I know I mentioned it, but there is all naturals in the key signature. So we're doing those F naturals and C naturals. But for the first four measures, no F naturals, no C naturals. So the first four measures should be relatively easy for us. Starting on that note C, let me play it for you. I'll give you a second to practice it, and then we'll do it together. It's going to sound like this. Making sure that we play those eighth notes fast enough and the quarter notes long enough. Go ahead and pause the video to play through that. Make sure you have it down, and then we'll do it together. All right, here we go. Find that C. Should sound like that. Right in the middle of the bow here to play this. Ready, and here we go. Awesome. The next section here, we start on a G, and then we do have an F natural, G to F natural. So let's do, I'm looking at measures 5 and 6. Measures 5 and 6 will sound like this. If you're getting that F natural in tune. If you play it as an F sharp, it sounds like this. We don't want that. We want F natural like this. Okay, and then measure 7 and 8 should be, again, pretty easy. So let's put together measures 5 through 8. Okay, ready? And here we go. Awesome. Let's play the whole top line. And this time, let's observe the dynamics that are written. So we start forte, which is loud, and when we get to that second phrase, it is piano or soft. So the full top line here. And remember that F natural. That's the thing we're working on in this piece. Okay, ready, here we go. Awesome. We're going to skip the next section, measures 9, 10, 11, and 12, because as you can see, it is actually, I take that back. We are going to play it. I thought it was identical, but when we get here, we have E, F natural. So we'll just play through it and make sure this is an F natural when you get here, a low two or a second finger, depending on who you are. So here's measure 9. Ready? Here we go. Thank you. hope you landed on that F natural. And then as we end this piece, G, 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 F natural, D, C, easy on the note end. But we do have two staccato notes. So let me play for you from measure, what is this? 13. It's going to sound like this. Oops. So we can practice that staccato bow stroke where you play the note short, stop your bow, and have a little space. Okay? Try that with me, the last four measures. Ready, here we go. Good. We're going to go all the way through now. Again, if you need some time to work on this, you can pause the video and then come back and play it all the way through once you're ready. But I'm going to go ahead and play the whole thing, making sure I use the correct bow strokes, the correct dynamics, and most importantly, that I'm getting those F naturals, those low twos. Okay, right in the middle of my bow. Ready, here we go. Awesome. Nice job. So again, the Google slide presentation is up in the classroom if you'd like to take a look at it. You can also, if you have questions, send me a video and I can give you some pointers, and I would love to see and hear what you're doing with these.